With continued talk of a recession and many saying that we're already in one, the stabilization and even reduction of rates is top of mind for many consumers who are once again trying to time the market. Keep in mind that the rates we have currently felt low when coming down from 10 to 12%, but it's the incline from 3 to 4% that's got everyone's perspective a bit skewed. Deep in the hottest months of Arizona and with seasonality in full swing, we can expect inventory to remain higher than we've had in more than 2 years, but lower than we need to satisfy population growth from the last decade. While demand may be sitting just under average, it's the long-term population growth that eventually will cap our swing into buyer's market territory. So what is top of mind for our buyers? Well, depending on the part of the valley you live in, you might be able to get sellers to help you with closing costs, rate buy-downs, costs towards down payment assistance programs, flexible move-in dates, and even contingencies. Having been in the industry for nearly a decade, buying a home wasn't something that most people could do before they sold theirs, so buying contingent on the sale of their home was normal. We're getting back to normal. And how about our sellers? Well, normal for them would be offers without appraisal waivers or gap strategies, and fewer leasebacks, which may sound restrictive, but understanding what has happened with appreciation, the only way to ensure that your next home isn't another 25% higher in value and still needing a full gut job is to sell homes for what the comparables tell us they're worth. And leasebacks were only needed because there wasn't anything to buy, and we've started to fix that problem. In fact, what many people see as a problem is really the solution to the problems we've had over the last couple of years. The solutions to the problems we were facing feel like the problems when the market shifts. We didn't have inventory, so we introduced leasebacks. Now we've started to fix the inventory problem, and taking away leasebacks feels like the problem. The best thing that you can do is to limit the noise when making sound financial decisions for you and your family. Instead of comparing what rates were to what they are, compare your budget to the house payment and determine if you can afford it or step into it. Then look at the potential loss and gain of being in a home that suits your needs or a rental property whose principal is being paid down by a renter. Clients are so worried about a 6% mortgage, but we'll all carry $25,000 for the majority of our adult life on a 22% credit card, or pay rent, which is 100% interest. It's all noise, it's all perspective, it's all fear-based, and it's all going to change because the market is not stagnant. Don't try to navigate this market on your own. The opportunity is massive, and with just a little bit of guidance, we can help you take advantage of it for today and for the future.